Good evening there, folks. Good to see you. Good to see you on this fine Wednesday night.
Yeah.
The last Wednesday night of January. Can you believe it? It's here. It seems like we just had New Year's Eve. I mean, it really does. It feels like it just happened. And here we are at the end of the month, the end of another month. We've avoided, mostly avoided bad weather, and it's been a good start to the year.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
I think we most of us can say that, very thankful for that. And so just happy to be with you back here on Wednesday nights. Last week, if you didn't catch it, I started a study on the book of Romans, and we did Romans chapter 1 last week. I'll continue on that next week. But, you know, Josh and I were talking right before Christmas that we thought, hey, let's take a little break and on Wednesday nights. But one of the things we really wanted to keep doing is our last Wednesday worship. So
yeah. Here we are.
Here it is. Here we are, everybody. So I know a lot of you like the old, good old songs, and you know that I love them. So we haven't really added one to the repertoire in a while. So I was listening to music, and I heard this song, and I've heard this song a lot over the course of my life, but never really did it. And we're going to do it tonight. And you're going to sing along with us if you know this song. If you don't know it, you'll know it by the end, okay? It's that kind of song. It's a sing-along song. Hey, Cherie, how are you? So good to see you. And so this is a old song, but there's a lot of artists who sing this song. And Gaithers, you can hear it on the Gaithers and a lot of different people. So I'd love for you to sing along with us. I'm the Lord thy God. God spoke to Moses at the burning bush. The burning bush, Lord, the burning bush. Yeah, God spoke to Moses at the burning bush. I am the Lord thy God. Take your shoes off. Sometimes Sometimes we just need to remember, be reminded of how God used the old people in the Old Testament. And, you know, I love modern praise and worship songs. I really do. But I think, you know, the Bible takes its time to show Noah, Moses, Isaac, Abraham, so many people, and we can go on and on, Isaiah, and on and on, and Jeremiah, Aaron, Jacob. I mean, it's all these beautiful people from the Bible, and there's a lot of songs about, you know, Jacob's ladder and Moses, take your shoes off. There's these great songs of our faith. And the New Testament isn't there, and Jesus himself said, I'm not here to abolish the law, I'm here to fulfill the law. And, you know, I think we can take and learn so many lessons from the people in the Old Testament. Mm-hmm. And maybe that's why I love a lot of those songs, is because they honor those fathers of the faith that came before us. So I love that song. It's a fun, easy song to sing. And the message is clear: when we need to honor God because we are on holy ground. Mm-hmm. So yeah. So and obedience. If you think about all the people in the Old Testament, it boiled down to their obedience. And so I think it's just a really, really cool thing. So really, the only thing announcement wise. That I can think of is February 10th, we're going to have our first family fun night of the year and our first family fun night in a long, long time since pre-COVID, really. Mm-hmm. And so what does that mean, Pastor Jeff? Well, family fun night is on Friday night. We start at 6:30. We go and we all gather into the fellowship hall. We pop popcorn. We bring snacks. Usually there's some cookies or sweets or something and some drinks. And we have a good time just hanging out, eating popcorn, talking to each other and fellowshipping with each other. And then we watch a movie. So we watch a movie, and typically, as it has gone before, in the basement, the fellowship hall, we show a kids movie, an appropriate kids movie that everybody can watch, and then we usually show an adult faith-based film or an old classic film upstairs for the adults. It's a great time. Start at 6:30. We're usually cleaning up about 8:30 and ready to head home. So it's not a late night, but it's a great, great time. And I would love for you to bring you and your family out to Family Fun Night on February 10th at 6:30 and experience for yourself. And maybe if you just want to get a taste of what we're like as a church, it's a great opportunity. So come on out. Bring your kids, bring your family. And we have several adults that don't have kids at home anymore. They come. So they can watch the movie and eat popcorn, hang out, talk, and just be with each other. And I think we need a lot more than that rather than less of that. So February 10th, love for you to be there. So moving on with the music. This is a song, maybe you've heard it, maybe you've not. But I'm not going to go into too great a detail. I'm just going to do the song because we want to make sure we worship God and get into this. But this is a great song. It's on mainstream radio, believe it or not. But it is unapologetically talking about someone sharing God with someone else. And it's really, really cool. And it sometimes when I first heard it, I'm like, what in the world? So I had to look it up and look up the words, and I went, wait, they're playing that on the radio? Not Christian radio. They're playing it on regular radio. And it's just straight up in your face. And I love it. It is a tremendous witness to, I know there are people out there listening to this and going, yeah, that's true. I need to think about my life. So this song's called Everybody Talks to God. It's by Aaron Lewis. It's a really, really great song. And we're going to do our version of it. And I encourage you, you know, maybe to listen to the radio version of it and go, wow, they're playing that on radio for people to hear? And yes, they are. So anyway, we're going to do this song. It's called Everybody Talks to God by the artist Aaron Lewis. So listen to the words. Him or whether you blame him, in the end, We're all going to face God. We're all going to talk to God. All of us believers are going to face God, and all non-believers ultimately will face God. And the Bible tells us there'll come a day when every knee will bow. Every knee will bow. So I love that song. That's a great song, and it's out there, and I truly believe God's using that song to reach people. Heck, it touched my heart, you know, hearing it. So with that being said, our next song is a song that's on Christian radio. So yes, this is a song that's on Christian radio, and if you listen to Christian radio, you're probably going to know this song. It's been out for a little while, a few months. So anyway, this is another great song. But you might catch a theme here, okay? Because the song Everybody Talks to God, you know, is talking about we believers are amongst non-believers. And there are times, a lot of times, when in our immaturity in our faith, that maybe we still continue to spend time in places maybe aren't the best places for us to spend time, or doing things that maybe aren't the best places, and doing things that maybe aren't the best things for us to do. But I know, I remember when God was just calling me out so strong in my life, and I was a young man in my 20s, and I was doing the Saturday night thing, and going to church on Sunday morning. And just like this song says, I'm thankful that God kept me going on Sunday morning, because those Saturday nights sometimes were rough and stupid, to be honest with you. But God kept calling. God kept calling me, and He keeps calling us. And maybe you're in a good place with the Lord right now. Maybe your relationship is great with the Lord. But maybe you do find yourself riding the fence, so to speak. One foot in the world, one foot out. This is a great song. If you know this song, sing along with us, because this is a really, really good song. And again, I think it's just a place where I just feel like there's people who are watching, people who are listening, maybe not tonight, maybe tomorrow, maybe next week, maybe next year, that are going to hear this and go, hey, I can move beyond my Saturday nights into Sunday mornings, and then Sunday mornings can become such an important part of my life. And what I mean by that is church. Church. So this is a really, really cool song. If you know it, sing along with me.
Thank you.
really is a new beginning, really is amazing grace. So thank God for Sunday morning, thank God. If you've got chains, he's a chain breaker. If you've been walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice say the same old lies, if you've been trying to feel the same old holes inside, Lord, there's a better life. There's a better life. If you've got pain, he's a pain taker.
Thank you.
Heavenly Father, I know a lot of people have pain. Maybe someone listening to this or watching this right now has so much pain. Maybe it's physical pain or emotional pain or even spiritual pain. Maybe it's two. Maybe it's all three. Maybe it's all three things. But a pain. Maybe it's a deep pain. Maybe it's pain that comes from an addiction or loss. If you got pain, He's a pain taker, Jesus is. If you feel lost, and I know in this world it's easy to feel that way. If you feel lost and you don't know which way to go, you don't know which way to turn in your life, let Him be your compass. Because He's a way maker. The Bible says that man, that we make plans, but that the Lord determines our steps. He's a way maker. Some of us don't know freedom. Some of us need to know freedom. And it tells us He's a prison-shaking Savior. So He can take whatever it is in your life, and He can shake it, and He can make doors fly open for you to have freedom. And He's a chain breaker. If you have chains, and many of us do, some of us are chained to our finances, to money. Some of us are chained to a bad relationship. Some of us are chained to our past. Some of us are chained to what the world expects of us. But God, Jesus, is a chain breaker. So whether you spent this last weekend on a bar stool on Saturday night and Sunday morning in the back row pew, maybe you were out and you eating and you were at a booth and you saw someone bow their head and pray and you thought, that's cute. Maybe sometimes you think about Moses and Noah and Isaiah and Abraham and Jacob and Jeremiah and all those people from the Old Testament. You wonder, how did they do what they did? Because they had freedom. Their chains of bondage were broken. They had a way and they knew which way to go because they followed the one who shows us the true and best way to go in our lives. We thank You, Jesus, for being our chain breaker. That for being the one we can talk to. Lord Jesus, we just praise You and thank You for this day. Thank You for this moment. Thank You for this time. Father God, I pray that You'll take this and it'll reach people and people will be touched by You. Not us, not our plane, not me. No. By You, Father God. In Your precious, holy, mighty name we pray. Amen. Can't wait to see you all again next week, next Wednesday night. Make plans to join me. Because I'm going to be on here and we're going to be talking about Romans chapter 2 and maybe more. So God bless you. I'd love to see you on Sunday morning. Thank God for Sunday morning. But I'd love to see you. 10 o'clock a.m. Sunday school. All ages. 11 o'clock a.m. Family worship for everybody. Everybody comes and everybody's in worship with us. And we sing and we laugh and we pray and we praise God together. And it is most awesome. And I'd love for you to be there. It's 8447 Sulphur Road, Sulphur, Kentucky, 40070. Show up, be there, and find yourself loved. God bless. See you real soon.